Hey guys, Lance here. As you can tell, another video, which has been rare, right? excuse me. Hopefully this year I'll be making some more videos. I'm just getting over sickness, so I apologize the way I sound. I'm trying to work on the audio stuff a little better. I broke the stand with my microphone, which is why, you know, lately the audio hasn't been so great with a lot of things. But excuses, but nonetheless, today I'm trying to make a video regarding something that I received. They were giving them away at CES, and my wife got me one of these. As you remember, I do have a wife, her name's Yulia. Sometimes she shows up, sometimes she doesn't in these videos. The latter. But nonetheless, she gave me hers, and basically it's the Arduino. It's a special edition. It claims for CES 2018. I don't know if they gave it out last year or this is a mistake and they didn't realize this was 2019. Who knows? Or maybe they made them in 2018 and, you know, who knows? Nonetheless, very nice of them to give these guys away. And so this is basically full-size Arduino. Does everything a normal Arduino does. Has Wi-Fi built in. This is, of course, an open source platform, so if you're looking to get into hardware development, this is a great start. I've made videos in the past and source code out there that I released for different projects. My Bitcoin wallet that I originally made was based off an Arduino, and then I had the custom Arduino created, and then I had the flexible one where I was making the smart band, so the Arduino is a great start. So this is the Maker MKR1000. It is a genuine Arduino, which is important, and you should only buy genuine Arduinos, or Genuino, I think they call them, or Massimo, as I stated before. And that's important, because I believe if you're going to do open source, and people should benefit from what you're doing, if you are going to go sell that, I believe, you know, the originator should get some kind of credit for it. Maybe not necessarily monetarily, but they should get some kind of credit, and don't call it an Arduino if the original person doesn't get something out of it. Unfortunately, with my Project Podcast, I had many people rip it off and not even say they ripped it off from me. They literally duplicated my project and released it under their name. So, there you go. So, I feel for them, right? So, nonetheless, and of course, you get the little hologram there. And it's made in Italy, which is great. I think that's really cool. We have something in Italy in my hands, and yeah, it's great. Anyways, I digress. Let's talk about this guy right here, right? So you have the little case and whatnot, you open it up, and what do you get? Well, as most of the Arduinos, you get a little sticker pack that comes with it. Thank you for supporting Arduino, which is cool. If anybody wants my stickers, let me know. But you're not going to get my hacked one. No kidding. Yeah, I don't know if anybody wants stickers, but yeah, that's kind of cool that they give it to you anyways. Neat thing, you know, get the word out there. But the most important thing that you're looking for is the Arduino itself, right? So it's really nice looking. This is a nice little foam board. And, you know, they keep it on there. So here's the guy in general, or girl, you know. Usually if it's got these, I'm going to call it a guy, but then again, you have the inserts right there, usually female. So, just so you know in the future, male, female, right? Male, female. Anyways, so, here you clearly have the Wi-Fi chip, or in this case, you can't really call it a chip, right? It is a SAMW25-MR510PB revision R3 from Atmel Corp. So it looks like Atmel maybe have actually made this little guy that's on this Arduino, which is nice that Atmel is working so closely with them. That's really nice. So what's cool about this board? It's lightweight and small. Now the other thing, if you're making maybe an IoT device, this is the way to go, right? It's super small, compact. You know, you could desolder these headers or just clip them off if you want, right? And get rid of these guys, you know, pull them off. Of course, a heat gun would be great. You could just pull them all out. And again, soldering iron. And there's tools out there that allow you to suck off the solder anyways. But good prototyping, right? So what else do I like about this guy? The way they set this up. Now, I don't know if normal shields will work with this. This may have its own shields. You'd have to look into that. But nonetheless, it's pretty nice, super compact. You have your reset button there in the middle, which is cool. Probably would have been nicer out here, but nonetheless, it's there in the middle, which, fine, whatever. You have your hookup right here that you could put a lithium-ion battery. I don't know how many volts of power you're going to need, but probably a good 5-volt power supply right there, or 3.5, depending on what you're doing with this guy. But it looks like it's mainly looking to work with 5 volts. So that's fine, right? What else is cool about this? Unlike most of the Arduino boards that I've used, it's very clear, easy, and understand on the front and back what's going on. Now, of course, you can't really say that with all the Arduinos because of how they are. But this one's nice that, you know, looking to the side of it, you can literally see what each thing is doing, right? Now, of course, you have these guys, you know, the GPIO telling you, you know, where's the ground and whatnot on your normal Arduino on the board itself, which is what you see normally. But, you know, right here on the headers themselves is kind of cool, you know, that I don't have to flip back every time. It's a small, minor thing, of course, but it's just nice to know, you know, like, oh, I'm going to plug something in right there. Ah, there's the 5 volts of power, right? Or, oh, there's the ground. You know, not have to flip back and whatnot. Now, of course, that's the case in this, because your other Arduinos, usually it's right there on the board. Very small, but this is super bright. For whatever reason, I could read this very nicely. I don't know. Maybe I haven't been messing with the Arduinos lately, but they're killing it, the way this looks. And it looks well made for what it is, and the board layers right there, pretty thick. It's got some sturdiness to it, and it might be why, because it comes with the price. Now, we'll get to that in a second, and where you can buy it, and more details, but I just wanted to examine this, and of course, looking for the official Arduino.cc that's on there, and of course in the back, but yeah, I mean, it's well put together, it's really nice looking, and of course, you have your port right there. For debugging slash powering it on, you know, putting code on there. If you've never dealt with the Arduino, you don't need a EEPROM or something to flash the chip, so to speak, itself with something that goes onto it, and you don't have to program the chip itself with another thing. It's all done here with some special software on the bootloader and whatnot, which we're going to write a quick thing in a second. That basically just change the built-in LED, which, if we look, we can kind of see it. It's super, super hard, but it's got that little L there, right, for LED. Super, super teeny. I don't know if you can see it, but it's there. It might be not showing up, but it's definitely there. Yeah, it's not coming out. Sorry, guys, but it's so, so small. You'll see it once we write some code to it. And then you have your on and charging. So the charging is important because, you know, if you have the battery there, you know, that's important to know. And on, of course, it's nice to know that your device is on and, you know, you just don't have crappy code or something that's not running. You did the milliseconds of too small that things are basically combusting. Which could be a problem. Remember, the amount of time, depending on what you're doing between sequences, can make a difference. So, nonetheless, let's maybe get into this in a few moments. So, we're going to just place this baby back on, like so. We can work with it like that. In fact, if you're going to do that, you know, probably best to, you know, put it more towards the end like that to work with. You know, so you could just plug it in right there. But yeah, so nonetheless, let's just quickly show you where you can buy this or where you can get one of these guys, you know. So as you see, this was $34.99. Now, mind you, at CES, they were giving like tons of these babies away. And I know last year they were giving them away. So maybe that's why it was 2018. Maybe they had so many they couldn't get rid of them. I don't know. But nonetheless, I mean, as you see here, the board's really nice looking. It's a powerful board. Has the Wi-Fi on it. And again, like I said, good for IoT, and they even say that right there. Cycle through the pictures, you know. I mean, it's a nice little thing. And see, here you go, without the headers on there. So I guess they sell it without the headers. Mine came with the headers already soldered on there. So, yeah, I mean, buy it without the headers if you're looking to really make this into something for your house. You know, like a doorbell thing, or who knows what, or attach it to something. Tripwire, who knows. But, yeah, so this casing is a lot different than, you know, what I received. So this may be more of a promotional type box, or who knows what. But it's nice, nonetheless. It's not this little stick here, but it's cool to see. It's like a pack of gum, you know? Yeah. And so what are we dealing with right here? It's a Cortex-MO, a 32-bit low-power ARM MCU. If you don't know about ARM, that's a great thing out there that's been widely available on a lot of things. And this is a SoC, which is a system-on-chip. It's part of the Smart Connect family. Atmel has been pushing for a while now. As you see here, low power 2.4 gigahertz, which is what the Wi-Fi is, 802.11vgn, which is, you know, fine. A lot of things are on the 2.4 gigahertz frequency. I prefer to have things on 5 gigahertz, things run faster, less noise, but nonetheless. And it has crypto authentication. Very important, because a lot of things out there don't have secure Wi-Fi, oddly enough. Not sure why, but they don't. And as we were speaking previously, this includes a LiPo charging circuit, so that's really cool. And so, like we mentioned before, battery power or external 5 volts. So yeah, I mean, as you see here, you can get some details and, you know, find out more. So, what else is cool about this little guy? Well, sure enough, you can obviously use the Arduino IDE or the Web IDE. So this has been, I guess, around enough that they've made it so it's available on their Web IDE, which we'll get to in a minute. But first, let's turn this baby on, make sure it actually turns on, right? So obviously, you got your Arduino, you have your cord, if we have it set up right, plug, boom. There we have our power on. I don't know if you can see it. You can. It's lit up right there, right? All right. So, we got our Arduino on. It's running. Okay. Nothing's going on because we have no code to it. So, let's go ahead and run the Windows IDE of Arduino. Now, the good news is you can go ahead and get this for Mac, Linux, etc. So, a bunch of different flavors this is for. So, as you see here, they want you to give you your setup and loop, right? So, let's go ahead and make some variables real quick. So, one, let's do int brightness. We're just going to make the LED fade. So, let's go ahead and set that at 0, right? And we'll just say this is for brightness, right? And then let's do another one, and then let's say we want this for fade. Fade quantity, perhaps. Yeah, I guess let's just say fade. Forget it, right? Let's do, like, I don't know, 3 or 5, 3, maybe? Let's do 3, right? So we'll say fade, fade amount. That's fine. So, here, like it says, what goes on here. So, because this has a built-in LED, and I'm not going to attach an LED, best thing we could do is use this feature that's in Arduino, which is great, called the LED built-in. Before, when I was first starting with Arduinos, it didn't have that. You had to define, like, pin 13. But now it's in there, which is really cool. So, you could do pin mode. Now, basically, the pin mode is saying what you're trying to do with this specified pin. So, in our case, we're going to do LED built in, like so, and we're gonna do output, right? Okay, and this is literally all we're doing to activate the LED that's built in, right? So now let's go ahead and, you know, set up the writing and access to the pin. So in this case, we will do an analog write, right, and then do LED built in. take what we had previously with our brightness and, you know, fade it in by the amount. So now we need to do if, you know, the brightness equal to, or the brightness 255, which is the maximum that you could obviously do. You need to do something like fade equals minus fade, right? Minus fade. So you could do the math like that, obviously. So we have that right there. And then, let's add a delay about 30 or 60. No, 30 is fine, right? So now let's verify the script. That's our other project we were making. Which I'll show you guys that eventually. That's using an LED strip that I found. So you could do Christmas lights and stuff. Had an idea last night. But anyways, let's just call this LED class 1, right? LED fade class 1. I thought maybe we should do more, right? So we're compiling the sketch, right? Now we're going to go ahead and upload it to the device and watch the LED on it. I don't know if you can see it, but it's going, it's writing, and it's done. And so now it's uploaded, and if you can kind of tell, it's fading a bit. Well, it's very hard to tell, I know. Maybe it's too bright in here, but the LED is fading. So that's kind of cool. The other thing we could do maybe to kind of show you also real quick, how should we say? We could try this really quickly. So let's change this to output. And let's say delay. Right. Now in the future you could do a variable for this, right? You know what? Let's do this in another video actually. Okay? Let's do this. Let's go ahead and take the code that we made. Let's verify it one more time, make sure we didn't delete anything incorrectly. Okay? Let's show you how you can use the Arduino Web IDE for this as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and close that. So Arduino has this Create Web IDE, which is kind of cool. So it's logging me in, and right. So this is what I wanted to show people. So I've heard a couple people say this doesn't work, right? I beg to differ. So let's go through the process just so we know how to do it. I was going to do another video, but hell with it. Let's do this. Install the plugin. Okay? Download the plugin. Put it in your computer. Download it, rather. give it a second. Let's open it and install anyways. Let's run it. This is very easy, guys. Okay, we're gonna hit next. We're gonna accept because what the hell, right? Do you intend to use other than Google or Mozilla Firefox? No. And let's go ahead and install. It's installing. Now, I don't know how anybody says this doesn't work or it's difficult to understand. But nonetheless, we're doing this together. We're going to allow access. Obviously, we have no choice if we wanted to work with that. And complete. And if the plugin is complete, oh, what do you know? We have that there. So I don't know how people could diss this product and say it doesn't work right. Whatever. And as you see, it automatically detected my device, right? That's kind of cool. So here it gives you the basic sketch and everything that we had previously. Run that. We don't need this. Well, it doesn't give you the option to close it, I guess. Whatever. So nonetheless, here's our same sketch. Let's verify and save. Checking our code. Everything looked good. You know, for shits and giggles, let's go ahead and upload it. Now, your system may have opened a dialog behind your browser. Please accept the driver and install. Now, I haven't gotten anything. So we'll say okay. But went on mine. So I don't know what they're talking about. say, but yeah. Oh, here we are. Do you want to continue? Yes. Yes, yes. So, maybe, oh, probably, I forgot I already put the code on there. So let's try it again. I definitely forgot. What I should have done was change the delay. So now it's uploading here. And it appears to be a success. Right? So let's go ahead and change this delay to like 2000. Let's upload and save. So you'll be able to detect the delay. So, do you see the fade amount? You ready? You'll know because it's a lot slower. I don't know if you guys can tell, but it's like super, super small amount and super, super slow. It may be a bad example, perhaps. And we could probably change the fade, too. That might help as well to kind of prove our point. Because that is very, very slow. In fact, you know, maybe let's change that to 30 back here. Let's stop that. Upload that back. 30 might be a much better number for us. With the 8 fade. There we go. That's more visually visible to see. Do you guys see that? So, of course, that's a minor, minor thing of what you can do. This is bare, bare bone basic. But it's cool that you can now use LED built in. So literally, the Arduinos are smart enough to know if something has a built-in LED. And guess what? You can use it. So how far have we gone in life that basically we can use a web browser to connect to our device, to write code, and put it to our device, I mean, via USB. We've come a long way, people. I don't know if you understand. I mean, it's a miracle what we can do now in a web browser. You know, Google had it right. The web browser was the future. And that's good for people with, like, Chromebooks. Imagine, people will be able to do development on hardware with something simple like a Chromebook. So, very cool. So, anyways, as we see, we can use the Windows IDE, or if you're a Mac user, there's that, or Linux, it's available for that as well. Or, apparently, any platform in USB access, you can use the Arduino Create Web IDE. And, anyways, so, I don't know what company this came from. I just received it. My wife gave me hers, so I don't know, but it did come from CES 2019, not 2018. But yeah, this was a quick tutorial about this product. I figure, you know, why not to do a video about it? Because I feel like we're going to do some home automation stuff here sooner than later and talk about this product. And what we could do. IoT seems to be the future, so I have some ideas of what we can do, guys. So nonetheless, I'm going to disconnect my little Arduino here. Hopefully this video was interesting to you. If you have any ideas of what you'd like to see, please comment, let me know. And yeah, if you have any suggestions or ideas, I'd love to hear them. We'll see you guys later, and keep looking for the videos. More tech videos this year. I promise, where previously I haven't been too good about doing that. But more stuff this year. And my wife may or may not return to the videos. She'll be home tonight. You don't need to know that. Anyways, guys, have a good day, good night, good morning, or good whatever